COVID Jaguar here, and welcome to episode 69 of the Dark Tower. Today, we are basically going to be doing some little odds and ends that I've been putting off for a while. And as you can see down here, my boiler is currently overflowing with charcoal. So, we're going to be expanding that real quick. So, I have the boiler tanks and the various stuff I'll need already, so it's just a matter of installing it. Of course, this is going to reset my heat levels, but that's okay. See if we can figure out. I do not think I have my harness on. No. But we need to move this pipe because it's in the way. We need to move it around the side like so. See, that's not good enough. We can put our tanks up, breaking the boiler as we do. There we go. Of course, that resets our heat, which means it's going to be producing basically no steam. As you can see, the steam's dropping in here, so it'll take it a while to get up to speed. I don't have a firestone. Be a bit of an effort to go acquire one. So, we're just going to let it be for the moment. Put our other engines on. Let's see. So, and my wrench. Now that complicates matters slightly. Yes, that pipes are an update bug there that I recently fixed in both Railcraft and Forestry. I'm trying to figure out how to run this pipe around without getting in the way. Maybe like so. There we go. That works. Except this doesn't need to be gold. There we go. Now we just have to wait for it to heat back up again, and we'll have power. More power than we had before. Probably put my redstone torch up. The engines will not work without a torch. They will not even accept steam, which oddly enough is a I get a lot of people asking questions, why my steam engine doesn't work. The answer, you have to give it redstone, just like every other engine. So keep that in mind. No, there should be a little bit of steam left over beyond the amount those engines are taking, like 10 millibuckets a tick beyond. I may run another pipe down to the mob farm, I don't know. Something to think about later. But for now, you can see my fuel is doing quite well. My oil tank is empty, and I'll probably tear it down and paint it before filling it back up again. Because it was mentioned in the comments that I should paint these to match the decor, and they're right. I should, but I'll be perfectly honest with you, I forgot you could even paint them. It's kind of a feature that I just kind of tacked on because people said they liked being able to make tanks out of any kind of blocks, so I forget about it sometimes. But anyways, the next thing we want to do, we have up here. I moved my tunnel over, like I said I was going to. But that leaves all this stuff over here, which I'm not going to move at the moment. I'd like to get a Thaumcraft Tinkerer's Wand of Dislocation to move these chests because they're all clear full. But that requires taint, and that requires finding a taint biome as far as I can tell. So I did put my water pipe in, as you can see. It's over here. It's kind of a backup system for the farm in case it runs out of water. And as you can see, this thing is stuffed clear full of things that aren't supposed to be in there. Anyways, what I want to do, this pipe here runs up to my fermenters. So I want to send my saplings up that way. However, the thing is that my saplings, I do not want to send just any old sapling because this farm picks up any sapling that drops nearby it, even ones that I have bred. So I only want to send saplings that are the currently active tree, the dominant breed. So I have a bunch of stuff here to do that. Some quartz pipes, iron pipes, diamond pipe. That should do. I need a wooden pipe and a gate too, I think. Which I didn't get. Let me go find those. Okay, we have everything we need now, I think. So the thing is, diamond pipes, they do not match against NTB information, like the genetics of the saplings. I need to turn this farm off, I think. But because of that, it'll match any sapling that goes through, so I can't put a specific sapling in the filter and expect it to only match that sapling. It will instead match every sapling. Are you all done yet? You're just going to keep going. Anyways. So, to fix that, what we're going to do is use a filtered buffer. Like so. I'll have to move all this eventually, but for now. We also need a sapling, preferably one of the ones that just got spewed out of there, which I'm going to assume is this stuff. So we'll put this in. That was fail. Blue. We need to put this in blue. So saplings go to blue. Now the filtered buffer is also the same. It will not match NTB, but what it will do is it will only stack items that match NTB. So what we're going to is put this pipe over here, and we're going to put this on here. Bring this pipe out over this direction. Go and put this gold pipe in, like so. And an iron pipe here. That'll route it past the tree chests down here. Now it should be intercepting any put our fertilizer back in. Which I'll have to go get some more of that in a moment. But any matching saplings should be going into the buffer. Which it appears that they are, so. Any non-matching saplings will go down here into these chests, which I need to actually probably pump them through the system as well. But I'll do that later, clean it all up. But what we want to do here is we want to put I think I might need a pipe wire. One moment. Okay, so I want to do contains less than 50% conditional. Like so, and I want to invert it. And to do that, I need this pipe wire, like I do with the engines. So then emits redstone signal, and when redstone signal is off, pulse the there we go. It should stop after it gets below 50%. You see it blinking. The farm seems to be spitting quite a few out. But oh dear. I may need another diamond pipe. Okay, diamond pipe. So we want to put the diamond pipe right here. And we want to put this pipe. Whoop. Nope. Not yet. So I believe white is up. So any saplings should now go up that come through. Actually, I need another diamond pipe for this chest, but it's full at the moment, so. And this one also needs to be sending them this way. Technically, only sand should be going down. This chest is full of random junk. It shouldn't be, but okay, we'll do that. Sand goes down. Everything else goes this way. It would, however, appear that I need more gold pipes. But I'll put those in later, so. That farm's outputting a huge amount of saplings. Absolutely Massive. I need to turn this back on. It can't keep up with the output without the gate. But this should send the saplings up to the fermenters. And there we go. And the wood goes that way. So that takes care of that issue, which has been causing me much headaches for a very long time. Now, any saplings that do not match these ones here should end up down in these chests. One can hope. I'm going to have to clean out some of this stuff, but anyways, that solves that for now. Leave our pipes down here. And another thing I wanted to do was, let's see, get rid of these saplings in my inventory real fast. What I want to do is to come over here and work on my library a little. And we'll take this. We have wooden posts. Good. So, I think, yes, if we do this. The shovel is quite awesome. Beats doing that by hand, that's for sure. Except I think I may have just run out. Oh well. Finish that off later. Say I need to go find a bed too. Now, the way these posts currently look is probably a little different than what you might be used to. When I added the stone lamps, which you guys haven't seen and don't have access to yet, I had to do some tweaks to the rendering to the pipes to make the stone lamps connect. Well, not the pipes, the posts. And however, in doing so, I accidentally added this central thing to the posts, and I did not realize that until much later. But I thought it was kind of cool, so I left it. That's not right. Whoa. There's a hole there. Anyways, up here is not where I want to rework on the library, really. I do, however, need to work on the staircase down here. So, I'm gonna go sleep and find some more wood, so I'll be back. Okay, I'm back, and I'm gonna put my harness on. Looks pretty good on the rack there from BiblioCraft, so put that on, and then we can now fly. Got my myself some more wood and stuff, so we can finish our floor real fast. Now, however, I don't really want to do a whole lot with this particular level, as I want to come down here and we want to move some stuff around. Namely, my table, research table, and my void chest. I don't want to move that too, but I will do that later. Oop. So we're going to move this up here somewhere. We have another chest here, but I don't think I want to put it there. I think we want to put this chest right here, our void chest here, and crafting table next to it, I think. An arcane work table. So then we need to that's not right. Now I don't remember precisely how this works. Yeah, there we go. Need to make this stuff. Here we go. Back into bookcases. Which I picked it up. I see it's already night again. I spent a little bit too much time downstairs fiddling with pipes while getting the wood, so. Maybe something like that. And put our torches over here on the sides. So if I put this on here, like so, here we go. Now it should eventually collect bonuses from the bookcases. Nope, that wasn't what I wanted to do. Not quite sure I like the bookcases right next to the right next to the research table. I may move these. So, I don't know what kind of bonus. We'll see what kind of bonuses it gets. We'll leave the rest of this stuff in here. I got a bunch more books downstairs as well. So, anyways, that moves our research upstairs, and let's see. I need to go find my crafting book. Because that might wait. Yeah, never mind. I'll do that later. I need to make a Bibliograph printing press at some point, but I think it will have to wait until I have my let's see here, my what is it, my experience. That's what it's called. My experience situation more under control, so instead we'll go ahead and make the staircase. Just like we did on the way around and up, so figure out something different there. Now, hopefully, this will turn out correctly, height-wise. That's wrong. Worked out pretty good with the other staircase below, which you guys did not see me build because I built that one off camera, which is why I'm doing this one here. I almost actually tore it down when I put the levitators in, but I just liked the way it looked too much, so yeah, that works. Now the other thing is that it's supported by logs underneath. Now, I don't know. We won't do that one, I think. But we will do this one. Need some more of these fitted abyssal stone stairs. Not much point putting the log down there. That'll do. Not quite sure. I guess we'll take this down. Or maybe we'll do something a little different. Of course it doesn't line up. Why would it line up? That would be too easy. But whatever. Looks pretty good. Now I need some more. Okay. This harness, my flight harness, is not quite the same as creative flying. I guess some more of these wooden posts. It's slower and a little bit trickier to activate, so. And you drop a lot faster. But I'm still getting the hang of it. Now, additionally, we put our railings, like so. There we go. Or, sort of. I think perhaps this does not need to be here. Okay. That'll do. Now once again, there's no pillar on this corner because that's where my infusion table is down below. Come on, come on, come on. These levitators are a little tricky to use. But we want to put bookcases up here as well, so. Lots of bookcases. I also need to put an enchanting table somewhere. Not quite sure where I'm going to do that. Possibly out here somewhere, maybe. And then maybe put the printing press upstairs. As you can see, I do not have enough glass to complete this very much so. Actually, I have enough glass. The problem is I don't have enough black dye. And for whatever reason, I am not had much luck finding an alternative source of black dye from ink sacks. And it's rather hard to farm ink sacks when you're living in an ocean biome because of the way the mob spawns work. What? What? What are you doing? No! Wasn't cool. And I think that just burned my entire boat down. Heck, it's gonna burn my entire house down. Stop! Stop! Stop your burning! Okay, I may cheat and reload this. From my backups. Cease your burning. Harness back on. I still hear fire. Why do I still hear fire? Yep, let's not kill ourselves by falling. That would be a flaming skeleton. Okay. Let's go downstairs and make sure the floor is not burning. Oh, what a mess. What a mess. I think I picked all my stuff up again. Oh, no, I didn't. Ah, there we go. Six bags. Got my pickaxe, my sword, my shovel, axe. Would have been helpful. Okay. I think we didn't lose anything there. So how bad is the damage here? It could be worse. Could be worse. I may rebuild it instead of pulling it out of the backups, but I'll take care of that off camera. Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. Okay. So, I guess we'll just go ahead and wrap this episode up here in a moment. So, now, there is a new version of BuildCraft out, so 4.2.1, go get it, and have fun. How did this work? Not like that. Well, one thing I could do is I did install some alternate textures as provided by one of my viewers. So, I may replace the balloon with the alternate textures, although I think I may tweak the textures a bit myself. Anyways, we'll see. That red's a bit on the saturated side. This is why we play the game, right? Because it's no fun unless something goes wrong. Anyways, I'm going to go do the emblem, which no longer seems quite as appropriate as it did when I made it, but that's okay. The emblem for today is light as a feather. Which gives us the feather. Which we'll go ahead and engrave that. Make a frame. Make some signs. Get our feather. And bring this over here. Light as a feather. The feather. There we go. That's today's emblem. And so we're going to wrap this up, I think, since I managed to burn down my boat, and we'll call it a wrap. So, this has been episode 69 of the Dark Tower. Be sure to subscribe to my channel and like the videos and share them if you haven't with your friends, and I'll catch you guys next time.